I'm gonna grab his. God don't ever let me see this man in real life. I'm gonna whoop his mother, Shawty. On God, I'm gonna whoop his.
All right, you guys, welcome back to the house where we talk news, celebrities, and hot topics. Today's video, we are going to be talking about Gayle King and Oprah, okay? Black Twitter is not having it. They are trying to get these two out of here. I think it's a little bit unfair because it's funny how y'all will turn on the very same people that have been advocates for your ass for their whole entire career, basically. But we gonna get into it. Gayle King is responding to the backlash she got from the Lisa Leslie interview on Kobe Bryant. Okay, so we gonna get into some things. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to the YouTube channel if you haven't already, and let's get straight into the video. All right, you guys, so we gotta talk about Gayle King. And I've listened to every commentator from the anchors on MSNBC to Jason Lee on Hollywood Unlocked to every YouTuber and podcaster and talk show host under the sun. I have listened to so many thoughts, opinions, and comments on Gayle King. And of course, I've seen all of these social media posts about it, and people were extremely upset. Now, of course, a month or so ago, Gayle King did an interview with Lisa Leslie right after Kobe Bryant died. And she was basically asking Lisa Leslie about the allegations of Kobe's sexual misconduct with a young woman from a long ass time ago. So, of course, she got a lot of backlash because Kobe Bryant just died. Okay, you know what I'm saying? This was maybe a couple of days, a week, 2 weeks. I don't know the exact dates, but I know it was really, really soon where she did this interview with Lisa Leslie. And it got a lot of backlash, and I kind of understood where the pushback was coming from, because one, it was so soon, and two, Kobe Bryant is a beloved figure. And when it comes to sports and black men, you do not mess with their sports icons, because some of them will still defend OJ Simpson till this day. Okay, when the OJ Simpson trial was going on and he was being tried for the murder of his ex-wife and best friend, there were a lot of black people out there on those streets advocating for OJ Simpson, who clearly killed that girl and her best friend. It was just disgusting. And you know, sometimes people will defend people and stick with people because they are a beloved figure, because they are, you know, very talented, and as a black person has exuded excellence. And so it's happened with OJ Simpson. It's happened a couple years ago. Well, not even this, a year or two ago with Michael Jackson, when, you know, the Michael Jackson HBO documentary came out where the two men came out and said that they were molested by Michael Jackson as young boys way back in the day. You saw the black community really come out in support of Michael Jackson and really just go after those guys. They went after the guys. They went after the filmmakers. They went after the documentary. They went after Oprah for hosting an after special and interviewed the two guys. So we've seen this time and time and time again where the community just rallies after these people. Of course, R. Kelly, we have that situation going on now. We have Russell Simmons, with people defending Russell Simmons. You have journalists like Gayle King who, you know, want to get answers. And she asked the question, do I think it was too soon? Yes, I do think it was too soon. But do I think that as a journalist, you should ask the questions and bring the topics up that people want to know and people are talking about? Of course I do. I don't think it was a thing of whether Gayle King was right or wrong. It was more of a thing of, do you agree with it or do you don't disagree with it? It's not a right or wrong thing. It's just however you feel. If you feel like Gayle King was effed up for doing what she did, then that's how you feel. If you feel like it was, you know, no holds barred and she could have did it, you know, then that's how you feel. I personally feel like it was too soon, but I also feel like it was a valid question. When someone dies, their character comes into question. That's just point blank and a period. No one on this earth is perfect, and nobody on this earth who has lived on this earth was or is a saint. Okay, that's just, it is what it is. We all are human beings. We all do terrible things and we all do great things. Kobe Bryant was no exception. He's done great things in his life and he's done bad things in his life. Not saying that he went and, you know, raped or did whatever to this girl, but I'm just saying, he ain't no angel. Okay, shout out to Beyonce, because you're no angel either, baby. No, 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 y'all, that was my That's my type. That's my type. Okay, anyways. But yeah, so I feel like there was a whole wave of nuance missing from the conversation. When Trump dies, let's just give an example. When Trump dies, do you think that no one's going to bring up all the horrible things he did and said? That's just the name of the game. And I don't understand where people... And don't get me wrong, I love Kobe Bryant. He was, when I was a kid, he was... the Michael Jordan, he was the LeBron James of today. Like, he was that guy, like a legendary, iconic, great father. As you can see, I didn't even know much about his personal life or his family life or anything like that. But from everything that I've seen and read, he just seemed like an amazing, great person of great character. Whether he did this thing with that girl way back in the day, I don't know. I really don't care, to be honest. I really don't care. But it's a thing of everything is off limits. And this whole notion that we cannot speak of the dead, we have to let them rest in peace as if they really, as if their spirit really cares if we're talking about them or not. Like, it's crazy. You would think everybody died and came back to life to know whether people who are dead actually care about what's going on Earth. It's funny because we really treat dead people better than we treat people when they alive. We're gonna insert this clip of Gayle talking about the backlash that she received. So check this out.
I always try to operate from the do no harm. That is always my intention. When you talk about do no harm, that was certainly my intention in doing that story and doing that interview. And the intention certainly didn't align with the impact of the fallout that happened from that. But what got to me was the vitriol and the vulgarity that was just unleashed at me in ways that I couldn't even understand where that was coming from. So I say you may disagree with the story, you may disagree with the way I do the story, but there's just no way, it's just not fair or okay to be as vulgar and as hateful as what I experienced.
I totally agree with everything that Gayle King and Oprah were saying. I thought the backlash against her was unnecessary. The death threats, Snoop Dogg talking about some, you better watch out, we gonna come get you, calling her a dog face, B word, and all of that type of stuff was so unnecessary. It was so rude. It was so disgusting. It was so nasty. All for her asking a question. Was her question, was it misdirected in some way? It might have been, but did it deserve all of that? Absolutely not. It's just disgusting how we protect men, dead or alive, no matter what. But when it comes to the questions and allegations of abuse against women, it's always just thrown away. I'm just talking in general. This has nothing to do with Kobe Bryant. But why do we protect men who have been accused of sexual abuse over the victims who are claiming sexual abuse? Why do we do that? Now, are all these men, you know, guilty of sexual abuse? Of course not. Are all the women actual victims and are telling the truth? Of course not. But I will say that there are stats out there. There are statistics where factually and scientifically, okay, it is not common for a woman to lie about being sexually abused. It is very uncommon for a woman to lie about that. And I really want to make a comparison to the Michael Jackson situation, but I'm trying to leave it alone because I know that's controversial and I'm not trying to get canceled my damn self, okay? Because y'all feel so... I feel like out of all these cases, Michael Jackson has the biggest team of defenders. And like I said, I love all... Like, Russell Simmons, I used to watch Russell Simmons on MTV. He used to make appearances on Run's House. I loved him. I loved the whole family. Diggy was my favorite. I love Vanessa and Angela. They were such a beautiful family, and I loved how they mixed hip-hop with, you know, their Christianity, and I just thought it was really cute. So I used to be a fan of Russell Simmons. I never really cared for R. Kelly, but I didn't have a negative opinion of R. Kelly. I, you know, really messed with Michael Jackson. I love Michael Jackson's music, and still to this day, I don't think I can stop listening to Michael Jackson's music because it's so ingrained in my childhood. Kobe Bryant is an iconic, legendary NBA player. Even Bill Cosby. The Cosby Show is iconic. And I'm not gonna say that I'm never gonna watch the Bill Cosby Show again, and I'm never gonna give Bill Cosby his props on all the accomplishments that he's done throughout his lifetime. At the same damn time, if I think that they did these things, I have no problem with saying, I think he did that. Yeah, I think Bill Cosby did that. Bill Cosby's dope. You know, great comedian, great gowns, lovely gowns. But I do think he abused those women, period. R. Kelly, okay, he got a bob here and there, but I do think he's an abuser and he needs to be in prison for it. Same with all the rest of the men. And it is what it is, because I believe that we should not protect abusers. I do think we should have due process and people should be sued and going to court and investigated. But I don't think we should protect abusers. Abusers are abusers. They need to learn from their actions and they need to be reprimanded by the law. It is what it is. So this whole notion that we are protecting all of these alleged abusers, I think is disgusting. And as a society, we need to protect both parties. The abusers need to have due process and the abused need to be supported. The backlash against Gayle for asking about those questions, I know this went into a whole deep topic that really has nothing to do with what Gayle King said, because Gayle King is really talking about social media and all of the people that are going crazy on social media and all of the people that are, going in on her. This is what I'll say. Right now, I think Black Twitter and a lot of the Instagram community is like trying to cancel Oprah and Gayle. But let me tell you something. Gayle King is employed by CBS This Morning. Okay, all of the people under the Shade Room comments are not their target audience. So CBS This Morning could care less about what y'all gotta say under the Shade Room. Therefore, Gayle King will be fine. If she does ever lose a job or ever lose coins, she has a billionaire best friend who got her back. Okay, trust and believe. And Oprah Winfrey been true to this since the creation of that show. Okay, the girl is a billionaire. And even if Black people in America stopped effing with her and never gave her a dime to any of her books or magazines or websites and shows or any of that, okay, if everybody canceled their subscription for DirecTV and they called DirecTV up and said, we don't want the OWN network on our TV no more, that girl is still gonna have an abundance of money, because guess what? There's a billion demographics out there. There's a billion people all over the world who still want to tune into OWN, who still want to buy her magazine, who still want to do everything that Oprah does, because Oprah is the lifestyle guru, okay? You got Gwyneth Paltrow, you got Erykah Badu. They are doing what they're doing because Oprah made it possible for them to do it, okay? Oprah and Martha Stewart made it possible for Gwyneth Paltrow and Erykah Badu to sell candles and incense that smell like the hoo-ha. So y'all can try to cancel them all they want to, but Oprah and Gayle are not going anywhere, so I don't know what y'all think y'all are doing, okay? It is what it is. It's gonna be what it's gonna be. All right, so that's all I have to say about the situation. I really and truly want to know what you guys think in the comments down below. I'm sorry, this was not supposed to be a rant of my thoughts and opinions, but sometimes I just cannot help it, because I've been keeping this to myself for a really, really long time, and topics like these make me want to delete social media. Topics like these really make me want to follow all the blogs and the Shade Room and stuff like that, because it's disgusting how people react and talk about it. And it's just like, you have to be this side or this side. Like, you can't fuck with Kobe Bryant and fuck with Gayle King at the same time. It's like, you gotta hate one person or another. You have to vilify one person. I either have to think Kobe Bryant is a rapist, or I have to think Gayle King is a dog face ass bitch. Okay? And I'm not doing neither of it. Okay? So if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to the YouTube channel if you haven't already. And don't forget to create a great day. I will be back tomorrow with a new video. All right, bye guys.